Oh, somebody looks smart. There you go, love. Here's your coffee.
Thanks.
You look tired.
Yeah, I'm a bit.
Oh, you need caffeine, that's what. Get it down, it'll revive you. You know what? When all the other kids see you in your new clothes, you're going to be the talk of the square. Do you know that?
Talk of the square. Just like his mum.
Hey, come on. I thought we'd sorted all this out.
Nothing's changed.
Look, we've just been through a bad patch, that's all. Look, I thought we'd agree to put it all behind us.
Yeah, but that's just you and me, isn't it?
Where is
well, who else matters? I mean, all this Richard stuff, it's over, it's finished.
No, it's not. It won't be able to. People only stop believing all the lies he's spread about
just
me.
Just forget him.
Just
who
forget
cares what
him.
Anybody else around here thinks?
I do. Come on then, hand it over. She's so sweet. And she's a good little girl, aren't you, my darling? How long for you now?
3 months.
What's the matter? Oh, come on, Cindy, let's have a cup of tea and then you can tell me what's up, eh?
What, straight into enemy territory, eh? No, I don't think I could face Catherine.
That's all right, you're with me. Come on.
All right.
Morning, Kath.
Morning.
Two teas, please.
I'll, get us a seat.
Your other half was in a minute ago. Your sister coming back, isn't she?
Yeah, that's right.
Poor old you, eh?
Ah, it's all right. She and Sanjay seem to be getting on better these days.
What happened?
Nothing. They just stopped behaving like stupid children, that's all. Just shows what people can do when they make an effort, eh?
You ruined my marriage, Captain.
You really could leave Ian?
Yeah. Well, how could I go and live with him when he didn't believe me?
You should keep well away from Richard, you know.
Oh, I've tried. Was that going to stop him spreading lies about me? I doubt it. No, I've got to sort him out.
Cindy, don't. Just ignore him. Don't let him see he's getting to you. That's what he likes.
But why?
Oh, don't ask me. He's twisted. He's sick.
Oh, you two trash him.
Oh, just one of your ex-lovers, Kathy. The last Mr. Right but one.
Meaning?
Oh, work it out for yourself, or don't you? Or there's someone between we haven't heard about.
Try not to judge everyone by yourself, Cindy, eh?
That wasn't very nice.
Yeah, I know.
And you don't care.
Exactly. She's nearly as bad as Richard. She flipping hates me. She's dying for all the lies to be true.
Oh, families. Why can't we all just be happy, eh?
Yeah, we don't, they say. You can choose your friends. But your mother-in-law, you're just plain lumbered with.
Listen, I've got to go. I've got a lot to do with Mina coming tonight, you know.
Yeah, but you haven't told me what I should do.
I have. Just keep out of his way. Once Richard's got something on you, he never lets go. Especially if he gets a reaction from you. It's all right, you finish your tea. Remember, just don't let him get to you, all right?
You finished with this?
Yeah.
By the way, I don't have to stand for that kind of thing in my own cafe.
Eh?
What you said to me a minute ago.
What, one of your ex-lovers, is that what you mean?
Yeah, right.
So what's your problem? I'm only stating facts. Richard is one of your exes, isn't he?
It's not what you said, it's how you said it. I didn't much care for your tone of voice.
Oh, well, pardon me for existing. Well, it just so happens, Kath, that I don't care much for the way you choose to believe all the lies floating around about me, all right? Why should I be all sweetness and like when you don't believe it? A word I say.
How can I believe you, Cindy?
Just start by trying.
Oh, I've tried. God knows I have.
Yeah? All I can say is, Kath, you ain't trying hard enough. Excuse me.
She's stark raving mad, I'm telling you.
Yeah?
I mean, you saw her with me, didn't you?
Yeah.
But what do you think?
Well,
she was definitely giving me the come up, wasn't she?
Well, she wasn't hostile, was she?
Hostile? Oh, I like that. Look, I tell you what, she was getting like that the other night.
Really? What?
She's stark raving mad, I'm telling you.
Who are you talking about, then? Cindy?
Oh, what makes you think I'm talking about her?
Oh, come on, Richard. The old square's talking about you and her.
Yeah.
So what's she done now?
Well, a gentleman like me would never say. See you soon.
Thanks for the coffee, mate.
Right.
So, come on, what's the latest? What's Cindy done now?
Oh, well, he wasn't talking about Cindy.
Oh, yeah? So who was he talking about then?
Oh, just someone else.
Anyone I know? Come on, Sandra, what's wrong with you?
Don't be so nosy, right?
What? Everyone likes a bit of juicy gossip, don't they? What's he done? Knocked up someone else's wife, is he? Come on. Oh, forget it.
You must have known something like this would happen.
I knew those people out there still thought badly of me, yeah. I never expected someone to start spreading lies and bring on to believe him. Well, you believe me, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I don't trust that Tricky Dicky an inch. I've rarely met a shiftier bloke.
But then why do people listen to him, Pat?
Why did you go out with him?
To tell him where to get off.
Oh, Cindy, come on! I've told plenty of people where to get off in my time. I haven't found it necessary to make a date to do it.
Yeah, I suppose it was a bit silly.
In telling me? What were you thinking of? I mean, going out to dinner with him? Sneaking off without telling Ian? And you wonder why people around here don't believe you?
Maybe he was just trying to be too clever.
Too clever for me. I don't pretend to understand.
Well, I just thought he thinks he's so smart, he thinks I can't see through him. So I thought I'd play along with him and then drop him from a great height.
You really asking for it, weren't you?
Yeah, I can see that now.
And as to people around here not believing you, think, what's your track record been?
Yeah, I know.
Married Ian on the rebound from Simon, fell pregnant by Simon, passed the kid off as Ian's.
I know.
And then you upped and ran off with Simon. I bet the well-wishers around here have told you the state Ian got in.
Yeah.
And now you're back with Ian, having been dumped by Simon. If you were a horse with form like that, would you expect anybody to bet on you?
Maybe not.
Definitely not.
Okay. So some of it is my own fault. But do I just put up with it?
Oh, no. No, you've got to do something about it.
Oh, yeah, all right,
hold on,
love. Yes.
Right, now here's my chance. Oh, no, Cindy, don't. Just leave well alone, like I told you. Anyway, what are you going to say? I'll think of something. No, Cindy, don't. You'll just make matters worse.
See me.
I want a word with you.
Not really? Well, I'm sorry, love, I'm too busy.
You can't think and get away with what you've been doing. I'm not letting you go and spreading lies about me.
Look, just get lost.
I love you for what you've done. I swear I will.
Yeah.
You're dead!
Hey, there's my favourite boy. You been a good boy today, have you? Yeah?
Yes.
Good. How are you?
So-so.
What's up?
Nothing. You want a coffee?
No, I'm all right, love.
Where you been?
I was put around Auntie Pauline's, see how she was getting on. She was asking after you.
I suppose she hates me as well.
Auntie Pauline, don't be silly. Why should she hate you?
Same reason they all do.
Has something happened?
No, of course not.
You got to stop thinking like this. Nobody hates you.
Oh, no.
No. Look, remember when you first came back? You felt this way back then, didn't you?
Yeah,
I mean, you were scared to be seen out with me.
That was different.
No, it's not. It's exactly the same. You mustn't be scared of what people think.
No.
Do you remember what we did back then?
I don't remember.
Yes, you do. We walked into the Vic, didn't we, and had a drink. Yeah?
Yeah, we did, didn't we?
Right. And what happened? Not a lot. A few people looked a little bit amazed, but that was all.
Yeah, but that was then.
Yeah, and this is now. Nothing's changed, really.
No.
No! Look, love, you're just getting everything completely out of proportion. Now, what I say is, we go over to the Vic and we have a drink right now. Yeah?
We haven't got a babysitter.
Look, don't worry about that. I'll sort that out. Now, you go over there and you get a drink set up, and I'll phone around and I'll see if I can get look after Stephen for a couple of hours, all right? I'll try Geeta.
No, she's got a sister coming over. Pat'll do it.
Yeah, all right. Go on, you go over there and get it set up, and I'll wait here for Pat to turn up, all right?
Look who it is. On her own two, reckon she's got a date.
No, you'll never win Landlady of the Year with that attitude.
Just taking a keen interest in my clientele.
Mine's a pint if you buy. I'll tell you what, brandy if you're feeling flush.
The only thing I'd buy you is a wooden overcoat.
Excuse me? Something the matter?
Look, just leave me alone, all right? I'm here for a quiet drink with my husband.
Must be the invisible man. Look, earlier on you wanted to say something to me, didn't you? Well, sorry, I was busy, but you can say it now if you want. Look, there's a table here. Come on.
Just take your hands off me! Everything all right?
Yeah, fine, Sharon. White wine, please, for my lady friend.
You've heard the rumours, haven't you, Sharon? You've heard all the things he's been saying about me.
Rumours? No, I can't say I have. White wine, was it?
Yeah. You see, it's all in your mind.
No, it ain't. It's all in your mind. You dirty, lying, twisted, sick mon... What's so funny, eh?
You know, you are so beautiful when you're angry.
You do all really hate me, don't you?
Why I'm angry?
No. Tell me. What am I supposed to have done?
What's going on here? Lover's tip, is it?
Don't ask me. I'm only the landlady. That's how I'd describe it.
You come in here calling the shots, then you won't even say what I'm supposed to...
You know what you've done!
Keep the noise down, will you? I won't have this behaviour in my pub.
Cindy, you're upset. Sit.
Take your hands off me, or I'll break your arm!
If there's any arms going to get broken around here, love, it won't be mine.
Sharon, you've got to help me!
Have I?
Tell him! Tell him you know what he's been saying about me!
I'm sorry?
Tell him!
I haven't a clue what you're on about, Cindy.
Don't look at me.
Yes, you do! He's been going around telling him I'm pregnant by him, but it's not
honest, Cindy, I don't really think I'm in a position to judge.
Now, why don't you let me buy you a drink? Sharon, glass of white wine for Cindy, please.
So, how's Stephen? Getting big, isn't he? In the image of his father, too, I'd say.
Where are you going?
Get out of my way.
You're going home?
Yes, if you let me get past.
Mention your little boy brought on an attack of the old maternal instinct, did it?
Let me get past.
Yeah, yeah, you go and put your feet up. I mean, you've got to look after our little family, haven't you?
This sort of thing just ain't good for business.
Another day and another dollar, eh? Hey, is that coffee fresh? Come on, love, don't.
I can't help it, I just feel so stupid.
All right, so maybe you shouldn't have confronted him, but never mind. It's all over.
I made a fool of myself.
No, you didn't.
And not one of them believed me, not one of them.
Well, that's people around here, isn't it? I don't want to get involved, do I?
I just can't stand it, all of them believing him.
It doesn't matter. We know what the truth is, don't we?
It matters to me.
Yeah, I can see that. There's plenty of people around here that don't like Richard Cole any more than I do. And I've never liked him. Even when he was with me mum.
Oh, don't mention your mum. I had a run-in with her and all yesterday, and she said she almost believed all the lies that were going around about me. Of course, she's never liked me either, has she?
What exactly happened?
Ain't working nightmare, eh? Mm. I wish we was millionaires, eh?
Yeah, lying in bed all day, sipping champagne.
Right. If we was together, we wouldn't need champagne.
Nah. But here we are instead, eh?
Yeah, walking through a dull old walk with a crack of dawn and a cup.
Crack of dawn? This is a luxury. Before I had Sylvia to open up for me, I used to be up by five every morning.
Let's hope Sylvia stays, eh?
Yeah. Mind you, even with Sylvia, I'm still working all the hours God sends. Maybe I need to seriously think about whether the bistro's worth it, eh?
Yeah, maybe.
What do you think you're playing at talking to Cindy like that?
What?
Yesterday, you as good as told her you think she's a liar.
Excuse me, I've got a
business. Look, I've had it with the way you treat Cindy. I mean, what gives you the right?
God, what it is to have a short memory. I only told her the truth. Have you forgotten what she's capable of?
Look, just pack it in, the pair of you, all right? This ain't the time or the place.
If there are stories flying around about Cindy, she's only got herself to blame.
Oh, I see. So it's all her fault, is it? I mean, she was asking for it. Is that what you're saying?
Oh, maybe I am.
Yeah, well, how would you have liked it if people had taken that attitude with you when you got raped by Wilmot Brown?
You're a nasty piece of work, aren't you? It's all right. It's just something I said. Kath. Wait. Kath, it's me. Remember me? Look, do you want to talk about it? I mean, if you don't, it's all right. But Ian should never have said what he said to you.
I'm sorry. I'm still too upset to talk about it.
All right, in your own time, mate.
Yourselves. Do you want a drink?
No, thanks. He's well out of order, you know that, don't you?
So was mum. Look, you don't know her like I do. You don't know what cow she'd be when she wants to be.
I don't care what she's like or what she's ever said. And what you said to her was bang out of order.
Maybe. So?
Have you got any idea how much you've upset her?
Yeah, well, she'll get over it, won't she?
Do you know something? If you weren't Cavi's son, I'd chin you for that.
You just automatically take her side, don't you? You've got no idea what she's been like with me. I mean, she's been interfering in my marriage. You know she drove Cindy away the first time she came back to me, don't you? Mum went round there and she frightened her off. I mean, she'd love it if I behaved like that towards her now, wouldn't she? Phil, she's a bitch. I don't care if she's my mum, she's a bitch.
What's going on?
I didn't ask.
Well, you're no good, are you?
Nope.
Have you got any idea what it's like? Your wife's getting slagged off left, right and centre, and your own mother won't give her any support. I mean, do you know how that feels?
No, I can't say that.
Right, so don't come to heavy with me about what I said to me, Mum, because you just don't know. I mean, she just won't accept I'm with Cindy, and that's the way it's going to be from now on. I mean, she'd rather believe that scumbag Richard, wouldn't she? Well, of course, she's still got a soft spot for him, hasn't she? As you well know.
Look, what Cavi feels or doesn't feel is beside the point. The point is, you've got your own problems, you've got to sort them out.
Oh, don't worry, I'm going to.
Yeah? Ah.
No, I'm going to kill Richard Cole. Simple.
No, you're not. You're gonna keep Will out of his way.
You've got to be joking.
No, I'm telling you what you're going to do, all right? Now, you're going to keep out of his way and you're going to keep Cathy out of it, right? You understand?
There you go. And if that don't get him going, he needs to see a doctor.
Thanks.
See ya.
Bye.
Good customers, they are. Buy something off me nearly every week.
Oh, right. Well, you'll have made the rent then already.
Yeah, well, I'll sort it out. So what's this I heard about you then? Some ruck in the pub or something?
Ruck?
Yeah, about Cindy.
Oh, that.
Yeah, that. What
about
it?
She's got to keep up a pretense, you know. Well, either that or hormones getting in the way of her brain.
Yeah, as they do.
As they do.
Cheers. Cheers, mate.
I couldn't believe it, Paul. I couldn't believe my ears.
But you mustn't let yourself get too upset.
Oh, yeah. I mean, look at me. I'm still shaking. How could he? How could my own son say that to me?
Well, Ian must have been really upset as well to do that.
Oh, yeah, and that makes everything all right, does it?
No, I just mean that... Well, he's heard what everyone's saying about Cindy. It's Ian just lashing out.
Yeah, well, from now on, he can take his feelings out on someone else. I've had it with him.
Look, he knows you don't like Cindy, and that's why you got it in the neck instead of someone else.
Well, it's right, I don't like her. And after this morning, I like her even less.
Can't you try to get on with her?
Oh, it's always me, isn't it? It's always me who has to make the effort. Listen, I know what she's like.
Yeah, but Cindy's changed. She's not like that anymore.
Oh, leopards don't change their spots.
Well, a while ago, I would have said that, but people have a nasty way of surprising you, don't they?
Yeah, you seen that Richard around anyway?
Now, what do you want him for?
It's business with him, so I've got to sort it out.
Don't.
What?
Don't get involved. What's Ian Beale ever done for you?
Well, look, I am involved, like it or not. I mean, Ian's upset and he's taking it out on Cathy. And that affects me, right?
Just leave them to sort it out for themselves.
What's going on?
Phil wants to sort out Richard Cole.
Oh, why?
Because he's upsetting Ian.
Not in a while, also. Hi.
Hiya.
Hattie, what do you think about all this Cindy and Richard business?
Dunno.
What do you think he's telling the truth?
I don't know.
It'd be terrible for Ian if he is.
Yeah, I mean, that'll be all he needs.
I won't put it past her, though.
No, me neither.
I mean, even if none of it is true.
What?
Well, it won't do Cindy any harm to see what most people around here think of her, will it?
I'll drink to that.
The sheer nerve of the woman. I mean, practically saying it was all your own fault.
Ian, it doesn't matter.
No? Oh, well, excuse me, I think it matters quite a lot. I mean, my own mother acting like that. I mean, of course, Phil has to get involved, doesn't he?
Look, let's just leave it alone for a minute, all right?
Oh, you've changed your tune, haven't you? This morning you said you wouldn't be happy until it was all sorted out.
I know, isn't it? Because everything we try and do just makes things worse.
Yeah, I know. So what now?
I don't know.
Cheer up, it would never happen.
Sorry?
Not so serious. Oh, he's not keeping a smile on your face, then, eh? Oh, what's the matter? Are you two falling out or something?
No.
All right, see you later.
I saw him, but I ain't tracked down at Richard yet.
Oh?
Now I'm going to get hold of him. Got to stop to all this. Well, that is what you want me to do.
Frankly, I couldn't care less. Look, this ain't my problem, is it? Why am I always the last person anyone thinks about?
You're not, are you?
No? Well, then why are you running around trying to sort out Ian and Cindy's life for him? They'd muck things up, it's their problem.
Yeah, and it affects you. I mean, this morning proved that, didn't it?
All that business, Wilmot Brown, and I mean, it's never going to go away, is it? It's with me for life. Cindy, she's poison. If it hadn't been for her, Ian would never, ever have spoken to me like that.
Okay. Listen, don't take me wrong.
But?
Well, maybe it's not just Cindy taking Ian away from you. Maybe it's you pushing Ian away because of Cindy.
Well, I'm sorry, but I don't like her. You didn't see the state Ian got into last time, all because of her.
Yeah, but that was a long time ago, wasn't it?
Well, people like her don't change.
Well, have you tried to find out, eh?
I don't need to.
Look, I'm not asking you to like her. If you can't, you can't.
I can't.
Whatever you think of her, I mean, Ian's going to be with her for a long time. You just got to accept that fact.
Oh,
Hello. What have you got to say for yourself?
Me?
Well, I don't see anyone else here.
Oh, let me guess. You've been speaking to Mother.
Exactly. Ian, how could you?
I don't know if I want to talk about it.
No? I thought that's why you'd come round here.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Look, she has been evil about Cindy, you know.
And that gives you the right to say what you did? Look, you go straight round there and tell her you're sorry. Yeah.
Has she apologised to Cindy for the way she's treated her? No, she hasn't.
Well, two wrongs don't make a right, you know.
Yeah, but it's a pretty good equaliser, wasn't it? Yeah, OK. I'm sorry.
Don't say sorry to me. Go and say sorry to Kath. Ian, I can't stand what's happening to this family. Please, go and tell her you're sorry.
What are you doing here?
I just came to say I was sorry.
I see.
Mum, I'm really, really sorry.
Been looking for you.
Oh, yeah, what?
I want a word.
Well, I'm listening.
Not here.
Cheers.
What's going on?
Who knows?
Don't know why Phil's bothering. Cindy's never done him no favours, has she?
Now that, I wouldn't know.
Cindy? Well, what's Cindy got to do with you?
Plenty. She's upset. Ian's upset. So naturally enough, Kathy's upset too.
Poor you, eh? Lumbered with that lot. Everyone round here is forever sticking their nose into everyone else's business.
Yeah. And gossiping about everyone else.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Why are you saying that Cindy's pregnant by you?
Who says she isn't? Okay, so maybe I implied one or two things that weren't strictly kosher. So,
who cares?
You know, people round here can't take a joke.
It's not just what you said.
Mum, I told you. I'm really sorry.
Well, things have been building up anyway, aren't they, between me and you?
Things have been better, yeah.
I just don't want to see you hurt again.
Meaning Cindy?
Yeah.
Mum, that's all in the past. She's changed. She has. And even though she hadn't...
What?
It's my life. You've got to let me live it my own way. Mum, I don't want things to go on like this, you and Cindy hating each other.
No, I suppose you do.
Don't you reckon it's time that... Well, we all tried a little bit harder. Life's too short for all this.
A long time dead, eh? Yeah. All right, then.
Look, I told you. It was just a laugh.
A laugh. You know, this isn't about Ian and Cindy. This is about Kathy.
What?
I think he was keeping Kathy's bed warm long before my brother.
OK, so we differ about what we find funny. Fine. I promise that the name Cindy will never pass these lips again.
How about it? No, I just don't get you at all. Now, you've got 1 minute to tell me what's going on. Otherwise, you're going to find yourself picking your teeth up off the floor one by one. You understand what I'm saying?
What do you want me to say? I already told you.
Yeah, it was a laugh. Well, that ain't good enough, all right? Now, you've got 30 seconds.
Look, that is just the way it is. It was a joke. You know, one of them things you used to have a lot of in the good old days.
10.
She was begging for it. Did she tell you that? I bet she didn't. Just so happened I wasn't interested in her.
Well, I hope you got a good dentist.
You wanted the truth. Right, fine. That entire mob get on my nerves. That holier-than-thou Cathy, a paranoid skinflint of a son Ian and his jumped-up wife. I don't like them, and I wanted them to know it, so I thought I'd make them squirm for a bit. You wanted the truth, there you are.
Oh, I wonder where you were.
Yeah, love. I've brought somebody round to see you.
Ian tells me I owe you an apology.
Yeah, let's hope so. Thanks, Phil.
Yeah, well, I still reckon you shouldn't have said anything to him.
Why not?
Well, it's down to me. I don't want other people getting involved, do I?
Well, if that's how you feel about it, I'll go and tell them to forget it, shall I? I'll say, Richard, I was only joking. You can go back spreading the dirt about Cindy. You prefer that, would you?
No, but...
Come on, it's all been sorted now. Let's not start arguing again.
Yeah, because that's exactly what Richard would like, isn't it?
Yeah, all right, you're right.
Right, well, let's all have a drink then, having heard the last of all this.
Yeah, definitely.
What do you reckon, Catherine? You know him better than we all do. I'm sorry, I didn't mean that.
I just slipped out, did it?
Come, let's have another drink. He's really all right.
Could have burnt the house down by now.
Stop worrying, will you, darling? We haven't heard the fire engine yet.
Still don't think we should let Ricky alone.
Okay, okay, okay. We'll finish our drinks and we'll take a steady walk back over there, okay?
I don't believe it.
Eva, a pint, please, Sharon. So you brought the family? Yeah, that's what I like to see. Nice, wholesome, old-fashioned East End values. Lovely.
I'm glad you came in, Richard, because now you've got the perfect opportunity to apologise to Cindy publicly.
Good idea. Why don't you?
Cathy, what's going on?
Richard's about to say something.
I don't want no trouble.
It's all right, you won't get any.
Well.
Sorry, love. How's that?
Say it properly.
I apologise, Cindy. You're not having my kid. I just made it up for the hell of it.
Yeah.
And the reason you're not having my kid is we never had it off in the first place.
Yeah, right.
All right, everybody happy? And the reason we didn't have it off in the first place is you're a dog and I wouldn't touch you with a 10-foot barge pole.
Never a dull moment.
Hey, come on. Hey, this isn't good for you. It's not good for the babies, is it? And come on, come on.